All right, our composite solids lesson here is really a composite lesson of all the other ones we've done recently. We've individually gone over in the last few lessons the volume of a prism, the volume of a cylinder, the surface area of a cylinder, the volume and surface area of a pyramid, and the circle or the sphere and the cone. So I'm just going to review those really quick, but the example questions in this lesson are really just practicing putting these shapes together. So composite solids are just solids that are built up of shapes built on top of each other. So maybe you'll have a cylinder with a cone on top of it, or you'll have a cube with a pyramid on top of it. So you end up with shapes that look kind of funky, like maybe a house. You have a three-dimensional figure of a house, then what you have is a cube with a prism, triangular prism on top of it, or a pyramid on top of it, depending on the house. So you just figure the volume of the pyramid first, and then the volume of the cube, and then you add them together. So I'm just going to review the formulas for the different shapes really quick, and then we'll apply those formulas to the actual example questions. So volume of a prism is just the base, the area of the base, times the height. So you take the area of whatever shape is the not the dimensions in between. So you're going to have a top and a bottom that are the same, and then you're going to have sides that are all formed of rectangles. Whether this is a triangle on the end, or a pentagon on the end, or a square on the end, maybe one of a bazillion different shapes on the end, then there'll be rectangles that'll connect that end to another end that matches the first one exactly. So all you have to do is find the area of the two ends, and then take that area and multiply it by whatever the length or the height of the figure is. So it's pretty straightforward. Then to find the area, the surface area, you just find the area of each of those faces individually. So if we find the area of the face, then we just multiply that by two because there's two of those faces, and then we figure out whatever the length going back this way is here. And that becomes one of the dimensions for your rectangles that sort of wrap up so that you can find the area of the three rectangles for a triangular prism here and the area of the two triangles separately. And then you just add all those totals up to get the surface area. So it's really pretty straightforward. And we'll do a couple examples of those. Surface area of a right cylinder. Surface area is, again, same formula, really. You're just finding the area of the circle on top and the area of the circle on the bottom. And then you find the area of the side that sort of connects them. The kind of important thing to remember is that the height, or the area of the side that connects the top and bottom circles, is going to be a rectangle that's formed by dimensions that are the same as the height going up and down, and then the circumference of the circle going along. So if I were to split this thing open and lay it out flat, like so, then the rectangle that sort of wraps around the middle is h, and then up here it's 2 pi r, or the circumference of the circle based on that radius. So the volume of a circle is the same as the volume of a prism, or of a triangular prism, and that's just the area of the base times the height. So the area of a base on a cylinder is pi r squared, because that's the area of a circle, and then you multiply that by the height. So that's pretty straightforward. Just remember area of the base times the height, and that's going to be the same for pretty much any of those similar shapes. Then things change a little bit when we get into a pyramid, because it's no longer one shape on top and one shape on the bottom. It's only a single shape for a base, and then it comes to a point. So that's where things change from that same area of a base times height for the volume. The surface area of a pyramid is just the surface area of the base, and then the surface area of one of the triangles that forms the sides, and then multiply that by the number of triangles. And that number of triangles will be the same as the number of sides of the base, because you have one triangle that comes up from each side of that base, see? So you just count the number of sides of your base shape, and that's the number that you multiply the area of each of the side triangles by to get the total area of the triangles, and you just add that to the area of the base to get the surface area. The volume of a pyramid is the same as the volume of the cone, which is one third of the area of the base times the height. So again, it's similar to volume of a prism or volume of a cylinder, where you had the area of the base times the height, but when you come to a point, whether it's for a pyramid or for a cone, you take one third of that area of the base times the height instead of the whole area of the base times the height. So just remember, if it comes to a point, then you only get one third of that total. But otherwise, it's the same calculation. Then for the cone, The cone is, again, for the volume, it's the same as the pyramid. Oops. For the volume, it's the same as the pyramid, the one third of the area of the base. This time it's a circle times the height. So that's a good one to remember. You're going to use it over and over again. One third the area of the base times the height if it comes to a point. And then the surface area is the area of the circle base, pi r squared, plus pi times the radius times the lateral height, or this slant height right here. The slant height right here is either going to be labeled L usually, or R. And I mean not R. I apologize. S. S for slant height. L for lateral, or S for slant. So whether this is L or S, you're just going to take that dimension times your radius times pi to get this area over here. And then you'll add that to the area of the circle on the bottom, and the circle formula is always the same. And then finally, we have surface area of a sphere. Surface area of the sphere is just 4 pi times r squared, so very similar to the area of a circle, which is just pi r squared. If it's a sphere, the whole sphere, you just take your pi r squared and multiply by 4. And then to find the volume of a sphere, you take 4 thirds of pi times your radius cubed. So, just a quick review of those formulas. I would recommend making a note card, putting them on it, because referring to the formulas is easy if you had the formulas available. Memorizing them, of course, is even better. At least the basic ideas of if it comes to a point, you take a third of the area of the base times the height, and if it doesn't come to a point, it's just the area of the base times the height. Those things are nice to remember. But if you're not going to, just make sure you get a piece of note card or something and write those down so you can refer to them. All right, let's play with the example questions a little bit and apply those formulas.